and it's what children have. You know, they look at you, it's very trusting, very caring. I'm going to be delighted to hold you. But what you have is the same kind of attitude that he wants us to have. And he says, I tell you the truth, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it. And he took the children in his arm, and he put his hands on them, and he blessed them. And essentially, this is where we get the service of dedication. But as I was reminding Sabrina the other day, that this service is more of a rededication of the parents than it is of the child. Sabrina, you know, you just have Sophia, didn't have any idea what was going to happen today. She doesn't realize where she is, probably, and, you know, you're going to later on, you're going to tell her. You know, you are just an amazing young little lady. Yes, you are. You were just so proud of yourself today. Your parents are proud of you, too. Yes, they are. Yeah. You get these little rings. Well, they're not yours, though, are they? They're just make believe. Okay. So what we're saying, I think I remember. That is the rededication of yourself. Recognizing that Sophia has been a gift from God. With every gift he gives to us, he gives responsibilities. And so he has entrusted into you, to you, a life that you're to invest on and to invest in. And that investment means that you really need to share with her that God loves her. How is she going to see that? They're going to take on the values that you have, that you go to church, you sing, you read scripture. They see something of the importance in your life. And if they see the importance in you, then it seems to be important to them. And so that they then can come to a point of deciding whether they want to follow Christ or not. And so as you stand before family and friends, and I think you've got a number of families out there, I can see they all have cameras. If you wonder where the cameras are. They all have cameras out there taking pictures here. But as you stand before them with the reaffirmation that you're thanking God for the life that he has given to you, and with his enablement and his grace, that you really want to invest in her life so that she comes to an early age of knowing Christ as her Savior. That's your intent for standing here. Would you signify by saying it is? Now, you have chosen an interesting name, Sophia. Okay, Dad, do you know what it means? No. This is unrehearsed, isn't it? Do you know what her name literally means? Wisdom? Wisdom? And you know what Leora means? No, that's not your grammar. Okay. And the Leora means brilliant or glowing light. So it's going to be one who has wisdom, who is just a glowing light. And she has been doing that already. Now, wisdom in the sense of not going up and telling you what to do. She might do a little bit of that. But it is wisdom, which is really just taking what the word says and applying it. So that you have given her a big name. And she's delighted with that name. So, okay. You're going to come to Papa Wagner? Come. Papa, I'm going to do it this way. All right, you want to show yourself? Yes. Well, Papa's going to pray for her, okay? So join me in prayer. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for life. We thank you for new life, and we thank you for the life that you have given to Sophia. Father, we thank you for her parents and ask that you might give to them the enabling grace to be all that you would call them to be as parents. We pray that the beauty of Christ might be seen in them and might be that which Sophia really just embraces as her personal own. I just ask there, Father, that for your enablement, your grace on her life, I pray that she might come to an early age of knowing you, and I pray, Father, for her parents this day. Not only pray for his parents, but for us, for family and friends who are here, that we might be those who would encourage this couple so that they might be able to carry through all that they commit themselves to do this day. We pray it in the name of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, we pray.
Amen.
Let's move back there. I think she sees herself in I have something here for her. It's her first letter It's her first letter from her pastor. So that you take that, and you can tell her who that old man was. But anyway, I can't congratulate you, but I'll do this here. Now, you have family out here. They've all got cameras. But if you're part of the family today, would you just raise your hand? You spread throughout. Oh, I got a hope. Oh, my goodness.